This Coyote Clips video will demonstrate a horizontal navigation menu. The navigation bar will be designed with 5 clickable text links. In the menu section, you will use GIMP to find the hotspot coordinates to make the links clickable. With GIMP open, select File, New. At the Create a New Image dialog box, type 800 for the width and 500 for the height. Click the plus sign to the left of Advanced Options. Click the Fill With down arrow and select white. In the comment, type author, your name, dash, horizontal navigation bar, and click the OK button. Click on the title bar of the Layers palette and move it to the right. We have a wider screen. Information about the new image displays in the title bar, and a background layer displays in the Layers palette. At the bottom of the Layers palette, click the Create a New Layer and add it to the image icon. Type bar as the name of the new image. The layer fill type will be transparency. Click OK. A new layer called bar displays above the background layer in the Layers palette. From the toolbox, click the Rectangle Select tool. At the Rectangle Select options below the toolbox, select the Rounded Corners option. And we are going to change, and I'm going to make this a little bit wider so that we can see it here. We want to bring the radius up so that you can see that the radius is set at 10. Click the Expand from Center option to make it easier to center the button. Move the cursor onto the canvas and draw a rectangle approximately 775 by 100. Now we need to be approximately in the center. Notice that if you look at the ruler at the top of the screen, you can tell when you're exactly in the center at 400. Click and drag, and we are going to drag until we have approximately 775. If we're not exact, remember that we can come down to the size and we can change to 775 by 100. If you need to scroll a little bit to see, we can do that as well. In the toolbox, click the foreground color icon and change to a light orange. In the HTML notation, I typed F9C. 773 and enter. Click OK and then click the background color icon. We're going to choose a bit darker orange. I selected F99D03 and click enter and OK. From the toolbox, select the blend tool. At the blend options, click the gradient icon and choose foreground to background RGB. You should have the lighter color at the left and the darker at the right. If you do not, click the reverse icon. Move into the document window and drag from the top center to the bottom center of the bar. Click the visibility icon beside the background layer in the Layers palette. This is selected, so if you'd like to move it a little bit so that it is centered, you can click the Move tool, move the active layer, and just slightly move it to the left a little bit if yours is like mine, so that we can see everything that we want on the screen. And then click the background layer. Control-Shift-A should remove the marching ants. We changed to transparency because a white background would not let us see the white border that we're going to create next. With the bar selected in the layers palette, right click and choose Alpha 2 selection to bring back our marching ants. At the bottom of the layers palette, click the Create a New Layer and Add It to Image icon. Type Border as the name of the new layer. The layer fill type will be transparency. A new border layer displays above the bar layer in the layers palette. From the menu bar, choose Select, Grow, and type 3 at the Grow Selection By, and click OK. The marching ants display 3 pixels from the outside edge of the bar. In the toolbox, change the foreground color to white. Remember that is FFF, FFF. Enter and click OK. From the menu bar, choose Edit, Fill with Foreground Color. The rectangle is filled with white. In the Layers palette, click on the border layer and use the down arrow to lower this layer one step in the layer stack. We can now see our white border. With the border layer selected in the layers palette, from the menu bar, choose Script Foo, Layer Effects, Drop Shadow. Remember, this usually goes behind, so we usually have to bring it to the front so that we can work with it. We are going to use Linear, Normal, 5.0, and offset distance, I used a 2.0, and 120 is fine here. We have a black color, click OK. You will see a little shadow display. Click the visibility icon to the left of the background layer. Now you can see your shadow better with a white background. With the bar layer selected in the layers palette, in the toolbox, click the text tool. In the text options, change the font type to sans. The font size we're going to change to 30. And the font color will be white. So we click the text icon, change to sans, size 30, white. Click inside the rectangle and type the word home. And then we're going to click on the move icon. Move the active layer, and we're just going to move this up a little bit. We don't have to be too precise right now because we are going to change the wording on these. With the home layer selected in the layers palette, right click and select duplicate layer as many times as you have links. So in this case, we want to duplicate 4 times. So we're going to click home, right click, duplicate layer. Click on home, right click, duplicate layer. Click on home, right click, duplicate layer. Click on home, right click, duplicate layer. So we have 4 duplications, 1, 2, 3, and 4. With the home 1 layer selected in the layers palette, click the move tool in the toolbox and drag the home text to the right to position it as a second menu item. So we're going to just kind of guess right here, if we have 5 menu items, how far apart we want them to be. Then we're going to click on home 2 and drag the home icon again to do our third, and then home 3 and bring this one over, and then home 4 and bring that one over. We will reposition these again in a moment. With the Home 1 layer selected, click the Text tool in the toolbox and click on Home. This will allow us to drag across the second icon, and we are going to type About. Then select Home 2 and drag across Home 2. And the third one is Services. And then we're going to click Home 3, drag across the word Home. And the fourth one is Links. And then select Home 4, drag across the word Home. And this one is Contact. Now we are going to drag to position these. If you would like, first let's click on a different tool, and then we're going to turn on View, Show Grid. If you want this so that you can make sure that all of them are positioned at an exact place, we could move this up a little bit, maybe to, let's type over the 100% and type 150. This means that we would have to move this back a little bit so that we would be able to see all of them. And you're not really able to see the home. So I think myself, I would prefer to leave it at 100 so I can see everything. So I am going to click on Home. Now we need to determine exactly with the Move tool where we want Home to be located. Now we can make sure that the bottom is in exactly the same place all the way across. So Home looks pretty good. Looks like we need to move about a little closer. So I'm going to click on the About link and I'm going to move that just slightly closer to Home. And then I'm going to click on Services and I'm going to move that over a little bit till I get that about where I think I want it. And then I think I could move Links and Contact over just a little bit. So I'm going to do Contact next and make it only 2 from the end. And then I'm going to click Links and center that in between. Now I look relatively close, but you can change this and be exact if you like. Now we're going to go back in and choose View, Show Grid to move that off. Now we're going to click on Create a New Layer. And let's make sure that it really doesn't matter exactly where we're located, but let's go to Home. And we're going to click Create a New Layer and Add to Image icon. In this new layer, we're going to call this Home Divider and click OK. Make sure that the foreground color icon is white. If it's not, change your foreground color to white. With the Home Divider layer selected in the Layers palette, we are going to select the Paths tool in the toolbox and create 2 anchor points for the top and bottom of the divider. Now, if you want to turn back on your show grid, you can. But we're going to copy this, so as long as one of these is correct, then we should be okay. So I'm deciding how far I want this to be, and I make sure it's straight. Once I have a line the way I want it, then I'm going to go to Select from Path. Before I do that, I need to hold down my Control key and click in the top. That sets our path. Then we will go to Select from Path. Then we will choose Edit, Stroke Path. And we're going to use a solid color, which is going to be whatever we have as a foreground color. Then we are going to change the pixels to, I think 3 would be wide enough for what we want. And then we're going to choose Stroke. A 3-pixel white line displays after the home link. With the home divider layer selected in the Layers palette, drag the opacity slider to approximately 40. I'm moving it back so that it gets a little bit lighter. Then we're going to click on the home divider layer, and we're going to right click, and we are going to duplicate this layer. One for after about, one for after services, one for after link. So we need 1, 2, 3. Right click, duplicate. Go back to home divider, right click, duplicate. We need to be back at home divider, right click, duplicate. So we will click, we are on home divider, so now we're going to click on the second home divider. We're going to click on the move tool, and we're going to move this line. So we're going to right click, excuse me, on the home divider, we're going to right click, alpha to selection, and then move to the home divider. And we're going to move this layer and place it between about and services. Then we're going to double click on the home divider copy, and we're going to put about divider. Then we're going to click on the home divider copy that we have above. We're going to go over to home, and we're going to drag that line again and place it between link services and links, and double click on this one and call it services divider. And then we're going back to going up to the home divider copy, and we're going to drag this over and put it between links and contact. We're going to double click, and I didn't enter on these, I noticed, so they didn't work. So double click, and we're going to change that one to about divider. The next one, we're going to double click and change it to services divider. About divider, and if you forget to enter, which I often do, it doesn't work correctly. Links divider. Enter. So now we have our bar with each of the links. Now you've labeled them so that you know what each button is and you know what each link is. So if you're looking at this and you feel that something is not exactly correct, notice that you can go in and you can change any of these and change their positions if you feel you are not quite correct with this. Let's go down and click on the background layer. And we can look to see if we're pretty close with what we have. Control-Shift-A to remove our marching ants. Now we're going to use the crop tool to crop our image. I'm going to pull this out a little bit so I can see it. And then I'm going to click the crop tool, and I'm going to drag around the button. Make sure that I have approximately what I want, and then I can click in the center and turn off the visibility icon so that the button is transparent. Now we can save this image as an XCF file, and we can also save it as a PNG file. So we're going to choose File, Save. We're going to save it in our GIMP folder under Buttons, Images, and this one we are going to call Buttons_NavigationMenu. So Buttons underscore navigation underscore menu underscore month underscore day underscore year. And then click Save. Then we can export this as a PNG file. It should already show as a PNG because that is our usual one that we use. If not, click the plus sign to the left of Select File Type. We are going to click Export and Export. You can then choose File, close the view, and click the X to close GIMP.